G'day everyone, welcome back. This is a bit of an announcement video. As you're all aware, I haven't been posting episodes over the last probably several months, but that's because we had a lot of issues with the blast and paint. So just thought we'd put out this episode, like nice and quick one, just to let everyone know that we will be coming back and we'll be posting regular episodes again. We have now finished the blast and paint, and it took a lot longer than I thought. My equipment was just hobby blasting equipment. It's like a little 10-gallon pot, and put that water attachment on it, and it did do the job, and it did job well. However, it did the job very, very slowly. The other problem is I used to restore old cars before I got into this boat. So I've had this blaster for a very long time, and it's done a lot of work. So all the parts were getting very thin by the sand media just like gouging it out. So every day I was blasting, every day I was also fixing the blaster because everything was wearing thin, every item on it was worn, and I spent more time fixing it than I did using it. So that slowed me down a whole lot of time. In hindsight, I probably should have gone out and hired a professional piece of equipment that, like I did when I did the outside of the boat. I hired a massive blaster, diesel generated blaster, had its own compressor and everything, and that was an amazing machine. It was very powerful, probably could have done all the blasting and painting within the week. However, that cost me $2,000 for a couple of days last time. So I thought, well, since I have the equipment, I've got the compressor, I've got the blasting media, I might as well just do it myself. I saved myself $2,000, but it took me, you know, 5-7 times longer than it probably should have. But then also, on the other hand, I was given some paint, and that paint is amazing paint. It's SurePlate, it's for potable water tanks, and it will last 10-15 years without having to do any repairs on the boat. But the problem with that paint is very, very thick. You have to use a pleural pump, like a solid state pump to spray onto the substrate. You can't just get a gravity fed gun and use your air compressor and spray it on, because by the time it pushes this really thick paint out the gun, it atomizes and dries, and it's dry before it hits the substrate. So it's very hard to work with the paint, and you only get about 10 minutes of pot life before it starts thickening up even more. I didn't want to spend the money also like hiring up the equipment. It's about $260, $270 a day to hire this particular pump that you'd use to spray this paint. And then you'd also have to buy your own lines, acetone to clean the lines every day. So that would have been about another $2,000-$3,000 to use that equipment to spray the boat, which I could have sprayed the boat in a couple of days, but I used brushes and rollers, and it took weeks and weeks to paint the boat. So everything I did took a lot longer, and if I was to be putting out episodes each week, it would have been very boring and no interesting content. So we thought we'd just make the call. We rather put out quality episodes each time. This is where we are 7 months later. The boat is all painted. It looks amazing. And we're up to the point where we're going to now be fitting out the boat, and all the interesting stuff is happening. So on the other hand as well, as you can probably see, there's no shade above me in my little gazebo area now. We've got a bit of damage over there on my little wall that I put up to make the background nice. There was a massive storm that whipped through here, caused a lot of damage, ripped all the gazebo apart, all my tarps came off the boat. I had to do a lot of cleaning up, so that put me back a little bit. We had a lot of family emergencies. Everyone knows my old man's a bit sick, so spent a bit of time with him. Didn't bother coming to the boat for a couple of weeks, and then we had a couple of personal things that we had to deal with, so I took a couple of months off as well. So now that we're back, we're going to be doing a lot more work on the boat, the interesting work where we're actually installing stuff. I've made a lot of purchases. I've got all the insulation in the shipping container ready to go in the boat. There's that much insulation in there, I can't walk around in the shipping container anymore. We've got all the flooring ready to go in. It's going to start getting interesting. So I've got a lot of work coming up, but also fitting out the boat is now the expensive part of the build. So yeah, a lot of money has to get invested into the boat. So moving forward, we're going to go back to our regular episodes. We're going to try doing them fortnightly. If we do weekly, I'd love to, but yeah, I work full time. The wife works full time. It's pretty hard. So we'll probably start out at just keeping it at fortnightly and see how we go. So hopefully everyone gets back on board and likes the content again. And yeah, I think it'll all be quite interesting. It'd be lovely to see this boat in the water. The John Pugh's beautiful design boats. I don't see many of them around anymore. I think I've only ever seen three John Pugh's personally. There's a couple online that you go for sale, but very rare to see them. So yeah, it'd be good to get this one finished and in the water and see where we could sail. So yeah, let me know what you guys have been up to in the 6 months. That's what I've been doing. And yeah, hopefully everyone's back on board and enjoys the episodes. Thanks, guys.